Another Alex Casey lunchbox? Another cult stash?
Animals stayed away from the water's edge as if to avoid some unseen submerged predator waiting just below the dark surface. They never drank the water from the lake. Birds flew around it, never over. Darkness flowed from Cauldron Lake. Gaze in the black mirror of the lake, you'd see it all around you, and you'd understand. It was already out, already where you were. It was already too late. Cauldron Lake used to be alive with people, beautiful forests, hiking trails leading to stunning vistas. Then the government put up a fence, kept the people out. Volcanic gas, they said. They didn't want anyone knowing the truth. The lake wasn't a lake at all. The dark water a mask to hide the hungry, bottomless ocean below. A fence couldn't stop the flood that was coming. Nothing could. The return of the nightmare rising from the depths.
Rose did all this for me. She completely believes that I am the hero in Wake's story. She should be a bit more critical of a person who tries to control people's lives.
Saga gripped the pump-action shotgun, aiming down the barrel. It fit in her hands perfectly. It felt steady. She had it under control. She swung around, ready.
more of those rhymes. Hey, another charm. Hate to see them like this.
And now, the sheriff's station? Did you hear?
Hear what?
Apparently, they locked up that crime writer, you know, the one who disappeared in Bright Falls years ago. And then, they find him, and boom, all hell breaks loose.
Big city folk, the FBI, famous writers. Ugh, they're all bad luck if you ask me. So, is everyone all right down there in Bright Falls?
I just don't know. There's a lot of good folk in that town. A lot of friendly folk.
And it used to be such a nice, quiet place too. Like Watery, before certain people came to town.
Oh! Hello, Mayor Setter. Nice to meet you. Well, that's the cutest mare I've ever seen, for sure.
Bailey ran around the corner as the street lamps flickered and went off. It was in front of him, a glitching cloud, a dark, boiling monster. Looking at it felt like what a stroke must feel like. He was sick with fear. He fell. The dark presence ripped into him, swallowed him, filled his lungs and his brains with dark water. Bailey saw a snarling face in the darkness. Then he realized it was his own face. He was snarling. He was standing in the street in the dark, and he was snarling. He was snarling, he snarled. The monster was gone. The darkness coiled around him in tatters and wisps. He was the monster now filled with rage. He was the monster now filled with rage, he shouted.
Some real strange news, I hear.
Best to keep your head down and mind your own business.
I suppose you're right. As long as they don't come and disturb our sauna nights, we'll be fine.
Another cult box.
Hold it! new.
That's all the stashes. These people were well prepared.
Thank you.
Another rhyme. That's it. Witchfinder's Station. I've been there before. Worth checking out. Another charm. Oh. Thank you. This has got to be an Ilmo idea.
They're too old to fight monsters. The torchbearers are done. We need something new. Ilmo took a long drag from the joint and handed it to his brother. They'd been drinking and smoking all night. That thing from the lake was not a man, and the government's trying to hide it. Ilmo gestured at the files they had stolen from the research station. The strange seal with an upside-down pyramid. The Federal Bureau of Control. We need to keep the feds away. Deal with this our way. We need an army of our own. Yako smiled. He loved to watch his brother come up with his ideas. Ilmo's gaze swam. It was seeing double. The pyramid on the folder was a spruce tree. A tree, he thought. A fucking tree. It was a sign. We'll make the woods scary again. So fucking scary, no one will set foot in them at night. That's how we'll keep people safe. We'll be a legend. We are the cult of the tree, and we watch in the night. We're gonna need scary masks. Energized, Yako chugged a bottle of Ama beer in one go. Ilmo Koskela jolted awake from a nightmare. He was drenched in sweat. In the dream, he'd been covered in blood, gleefully murdering people, his friends. When his twin brother had tried to talk sense into him, he had murdered Yako as well. Ilmo slammed his fist into his temple so hard it hurt. The dream made him feel sick. The dark force of the lake was growing stronger. It was trying to make Ilmo and Yako something they were not. Trying to turn them into Ilmari and Yakapi Huatari from the early days of Watery. But they were the Koskela brothers. Their mother had not raised them to become murderers. They had backbone. They had honor. They had Finnish Zisu. Something bad was coming. The hidden device they had hooked to the FBC station had been intercepting alarms like crazy the past few days. Ilmo would make sure his cult was ready for war. Out in the night, the story seeking to give birth to an overlap in Watery drifted on, looking for another pair of men more prone to corruption.
The dark presence leeches onto artists, manipulates their art. What power does it have by itself? What if I take the weird doll to the place it's not supposed to go? What's the worst that can happen? They're actually kind of cute the longer you look at them.
Thank you.
This bridge got fixed quick.
be too late.
Fucking monsters.
Thank you.
What the? Who is this? How do you know I'm here? What project?
What project? So you've just been playing around with my test arrangements with absolutely no understanding of their function. The hubris.
Indeed.
But your interference with my research has come to its conclusion. And I'm interested to see the results. The trait, I believe, is in the manifestation of the nursery rhymes. Art becoming reality, the doorway being revealed, and
get to the point.
Meddlesome and rude, I see. The point is that by your unwanted actions, you may have opened the way. And now I'll get to observe what exactly occurs when a subject crosses the threshold. No, wait, that's not right. What is that? Do you see...
What? Hello? Hey, are you there? Sounds like this person got more than they bargained for. Ugh, this stuff again. There's something else in there, too. This will be handy. There's a lesson here. Probably something about hubris. Man in lab coat messes around and finds out. Called it.
impressive.
Face the side!